Try and make it really neat and lovely. There. Oh, I haven't given you much space. And it's also just not my knife. I'm really sorry about this. Oh! I'll hold it and you clap it.
Okay.
Okay?
Or do I just... Sorry, just... There we go.
There we go.
Oh, oh, that was so satisfying. Well, do you have the lid?
Yes, there you go. Hi, my name is Kit Connor.
And I'm Joe Locke.
And we're going to take you around a tour of London to show you our favourite places. Where are we going, Joe?
We're going to Brick Lane because that was the first place that we hung out as a cast.
You see that? It's Brick Lane.
It's just so cool.
I think it's just, yeah, it's just really cool. It's really trendy. It's really cool, and you can get really cool clothes. And
that's the vintage market we went to.
Yeah, we went to that little sort of.
I think it's an old car park.
And that right there was a little sort of side street where we just sat and just talked.
Yeah,
and it was really nice.
Will bought this like incredible.
Yeah, Will bought this Burberry jacket with like paint splatters on it, and he still wears it.
It's so cool. Will wear that with pyjamas and like way cooler than any of us ever could.
Yeah, Will's really cool. Annoyingly, he's really cool. He's like, he looks cool. He dresses well.
Yeah.
He's just, this is basically this has just become our sort of our crushing over Will Gao, but I think it's fair.
What were the early days on set like? Did everyone get on immediately? Was there any? Was it awkward? Was it? Were you nervous?
I think it was pretty.
Yeah.
It was a little bit awkward, obviously, because like the nature of like Nick and Charlie, you know, they're meant to get on very well and immediately.
And me and Kit didn't.
Very
we did.
Yeah, we just hated each other so soon.
Still do.
No, but yeah, it was a little bit awkward, but
in like a first day at school kind of way.
Yeah, exactly. It was everyone sort of settling in, and then
by the time we started filming, we were all quite.
Yeah, we were all very close. Yeah.
We're in Holborn.
Beautiful.
Not Holborn if you're American.
See, I always call it Holborn, but I'm not American, so. Oh. But is it Holborn?
Holborn, yeah. So acting, how did you get into acting?
I used to always, like, every time I wasn't at school, like on Saturdays, I would like through two acting classes and then one after school and then doing some amateur show. Heartstopper was my first professional thing and it was just an open call. So like, they wanted someone new to play Charlie and then I auditioned and then managed to get it.
That's wild.
It's really weird. It's like, feels weird talking about it because like it doesn't, still not a real thing.
It's like a fairy tale, yeah.
Yeah, it is. It's like right now, the life I'm living has like always been my dream to one day do that.
Yeah.
And I feel very, very lucky. I think a lot of it is just luck. Like.
And a little bit of talent as well. But
yeah, a lot of talent.
He's got a little bit. No, he's very much deserving of it. I've been quite lucky in the sense that I've quite slowly kind of built up my career in a sense, like sort of stepping stones. I couldn't imagine like how insane it would be for like for Joe, for example, to suddenly go like straight into the lead. Like
all down to you. I'd be like, who's that person? Like, what are they doing?
That's the director, Joe.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I see. What does action mean?
So obviously we just drove through Soho, which is arguably the sort of heart of London's LGBT community. Coming into Heartstopper, you know it's a really, really important piece of work for like LGBT kids and stuff. Mm-hmm. How does it feel to be involved in something so ingrained in a specific community?
It's great to like that we're able to like tell the story.
Yeah, I think it's just an honour, really, to be honest, because it's so... I honestly think it's like such an impactful thing and such a proper honour to be a part of it and to be able to, you know, bring it to the people. Especially on Netflix, which is such a massive stage and
world
for so many people to be able to see it.
It's also
it.
Great that it'll be like in countries that maybe are early on in their journey to acceptance.
Yeah, so Netflix has such a huge reach.
It's the perfect place for it.
Where are your favourite places in London?
I mean, as the new Londoner, why don't you say it first?
My favourite place to eat is Ballon's on Old Compton Street. I love it so much. Like, I could eat every meal in that place. Their French toast is, like, actually life-changing.
Mm.
Like, that's not even, like, I'm not even exaggerating.
I love sort of Borough and the kind of London Bridge, Borough, Waterloo kind of area. Growing up as an actor, I did a lot of, like, theatre in those kind of areas and lots of great food and things like that. You're so close to the South Bank.
We had our cast and crew screening. The cinema just around the corner.
Did
you? Yeah,
The Curzon.
The Curzon.
Literally just around the corner.
Shaftesbury Avenue.
It was really great.
We watched all 4 hours of the show.
Oh, you watched it all in one go together?
All in one go.
We watched the whole, there was just a cast and crew screening.
It's just there. Yeah. We're about to pass it.
Is it weird watching yourselves?
Yes.
Yeah, especially like I was watching like the kissing scenes. My mum sat here and Kit sat here, so it's just a really strange experience.
Just all
like a huge cinema screen.
No, because it is. I don't like watching myself at all. So the fact that I was able to sit through like Heartstopper twice, I was able to sit through the whole thing twice, is testament to like how much I like it. Because I generally, Rocket Man, maybe I can sit through because I'm not in it for that long.
Right.
But then if I'm in it for more than a quarter of the episode or film, I can't sit through that at all.
It's hard when you're a star, isn't it, Kit?
What does the like huge reaction the show gets feel like?
It's been mental,
it's
really,
because it's crazy. Yeah. It's a lot, but it's cool.
Yeah, and we're so lucky because of the fact that it's like, you know, based on Alice's like previous work that it's already got that fan base already. So they care so much about the comics that, you know, when we are making the show, they're just so excited for anything that comes out.
Do they recognise you when you're out and about?
Sometimes I think you like go to like Waterstones or something and just sit by the.
Although I went to Waterstones. I went to Waterstones yesterday to like buy a book for someone.
And then oh look, the Heartstopper stand.
No,
I'll just stand here like half an hour and just see if. Oh yeah. Yeah, that's me actually. Yeah.
But you know full well that is the opposite of what
it's
I do.
It's not. Yeah, no. I think you do just sort of walk into it sometimes.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I think it's really cool. You know, anytime I do see like people who recognise me or anything, it's cool. You know?
Kit leaves the house in cap and sunglasses. So.
No, but not because of that. Just because I just like doing that. I can't lie. I wear sunglasses. This has sort of become a thing that I wear sunglasses.
It's very posh Spice of you.
Well, I mean, that's exactly what I was going for, yeah. But it's like, it's strange because when that first happened, I then felt a little bit insecure wearing sunglasses. So it would be a really sunny day and I'd be like, yeah, but if someone takes a picture of me, then it's just going to be like, I'm never going to hear the end of it. Oh, we're in like Covent Garden now.
Yeah.
Covent Garden's really cool. That's another one of my favourite areas.
Love Covent Garden.
Covent Garden's great. Great shopping, great. Just cool places, you know. And I did a play at the Donmar called Welcome Home Captain Fox when I was like 10 or 11. That was the first play that I ever did.
Little mini Kit.
Little mini me, yeah.
Mini exactly. Kit, which is
insert picture of me.
Age 15, looking about 8.
Yeah, I've always had a baby face, like a really, really bad baby face. So like when we first got cast, they had my picture from when I was about like probably 14, 15.
That was his headshot on the wall in the makeup room.
And apparently the whole makeup team was just like, I don't think you cast the right person. He's just really young. Like, really appreciate that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's showing his age now. He's got a beard.
No, this isn't me trying to desperately look old.
He looks good on you.
Thank you, Joe. See, this is, he's complimenting. This is really, you know when Joe compliments you, it like really
means something
because he doesn't do it very often.
Opera. Mm. Do you like opera, Kit?
Will and I did actually go to an opera.
You did?
We went to Glyndebourne Opera Festival. And I'd never actually seen an opera before because I'm just not cultured like that. But, you know, Will is quite... I think Will has actually been in an opera.
He has.
Because Will's like, you know, a musician. Again, we're back on Will Gao, but why not?
I can't say I'm an opera fan.
Yeah, I can't actually remember the name of the opera.
I love musicals, but I'm not an opera fan.
Do you? What are your favourite musicals?
Well, it's like picking between my children. I love The Colour Purple. It's my favourite novel and it's my favourite musical. My favourite musical at the moment is Frozen, genuinely. I've seen it twice. It's so good.
Really?
It's so good. Like, I went in thinking, like, it'll be like a Disney musical, so it'll be great, but it, like, won't be anything, like, actually good. But it was actually, like, genuinely.
Wow.
Like, the stage effects are, like, insane. That's Frozen. Best show on the West End at the moment.
Would you like to be in a musical? Any of you sing?
I sing a little bit, like.
You played Elton John. He can sing.
Oh yeah.
I sing a little bit, but not very. Like, I'm not trained. I'm not very.
I'd love to be in a musical. I just don't know if I have the voice.
See, I need to up my game with musicals because I haven't actually seen that many musicals.
I've never seen Les Mis. I feel like because I know it's never going to close.
Yeah.
To be fair, I was going to go and watch it last year, but then it was the day that I ended up coming to set to meet Olivia. So I was like,
yeah.
Tickets can go.
Oh yeah, because
did you go set just to meet her?
Yeah.
Well, no, because we ended up doing some reshoots.
Oh yeah.
No, we did. We did.
Yeah, but basically, so I had 2 days filming with Olivia. I had 2 days filming, and they were
going to tell the story like as if I tried to muscle in his days.
But it was no. It wasn't like that at all. But it was originally meant to be Olivia and I filming for 2 days, and then on the second day, I think Joe was essentially like, you know, I would like to meet her, obviously. They ended up scheduling it so that Joe had some...
No, that's not what happened.
Okay, Joe's going to tell you what happened.
What happened was I wasn't supposed to meet her, and then I got a call in the morning of the second day being like, we might have to do the reshoots from pickups of the just before the rain scene in the hallway.
Right, yeah.
And then they were like, so you'll get to meet Olivia? And I was like, well, if that happens, that'll be amazing. And then they called me at like 3 being like, yeah, can you come in?
The question of the ages is, does anyone believe that? Does anyone believe that?
A different day.
You weren't like, you know, you weren't like on the phone to your agent like, get me.
I don't have the confidence to do that.
Yeah, exactly. But it was overall a very nice day as well.
Yeah, it was really nice.
We'd been filming for the day and then you came and had a little chat, and it was a really nice day. Because Olivia's just lovely.
I was gonna say, what's she like?
She's just amazing. So like effortlessly good, you know. It was almost scary to act alongside her because it was just like, oh my.
You had that scene that all the fans are very excited about, which is the like coming out scene.
Yeah,
I love that scene.
Such a good scene.
That's my favorite
scene. It made me cry and cry.
Yeah. And when I first read that scene, I was like, in tears.
But that's the thing, when we first were shooting that scene, we were reading it through because, you know, before every scene, we sort of read through the lines. And, you know, normally you go like, you know, 50%, and then suddenly I saw like a tear like stream down Olivia's face, and I was thinking like, oh my god, like I need to up my game right now because that's what she's doing on the read through. Like, yeah, I think I got a tear out in the first take. I was like, yes, okay, that's me, I'm done. The great thing about the shot is that you can basically see it from anywhere in London.
Yeah,
like I'll literally be at home in Croydon, and you can see the...
Can you actually?
Yeah.
Really?
You can see it from South London quite easily, actually. It's just really tall, you know. It's
tallest
really
building in Europe?
Europe, I think.
Yeah.
It's building, at least. I think there are probably like structures that are taller, I think. I don't know.
You're wrong.
Okay,
Joe said I googled it yesterday.
Oh.
It's actually the 7th. It's not actually that tall.
It was, no, it was, definitely never the tallest.
It was never the tallest.
It was never the tallest.
Huh? I've been lied to.
Yeah. Well, that's just upsetting, really.
I feel really let down.
It's really ruined that for us.
I've spent like double the amount of time in London as I have in the Isle of Man the last year, so I feel like I know London quite well.
Yeah, you've suddenly been like a proper Londoner now. Actually, you spent more time in London recently than I have.
London just naturally calls to me. Like,
shut up. Dramatic thing I've ever.
No, I mean like.
You listen really carefully.
It just calls.
You know what? I sometimes.
How does London call to you, Joe?
You know what? It's fine, Kit. It's fine.
Thank you very much for coming on our tour around London today.
It was rather chaotic, but very fun. And don't forget to watch Heartstopper on Netflix.
April 22nd.
Probably already out by the time they watch it.
Well then, and onwards.
Yeah, forever, every day, rewatch it.
All around the world.